Asuno Yoichi, Samurai Harem. Two of my favorite things, harem anime and samurai anime. Does it make for a good series? If I see sexy anime girls, cute anime girls, you name it, I'm gonna go check it out. And this seemed like Kenshin, but with sexy anime girls. And I was right, it was kinda like that, although it's more comedy again, you know, and definitely on the harem aspect. Romance, ecchi, you know, stuff like that, so, but also shonen. A shonen anime I like? Anyway. wait, I did say I like Rurouni Kenshin. You got me, shonen people. Maybe it's just generic shonen I don't like. But it was a nice, cute little story. I mean, the one girl, purple hair girl, love them purple hair girls. She definitely has the Miss Kaoru look, I mean, to a T. And I really like that. And I love her little, like, the Misty, the Brock thing, pull by the ear, like, you know, typical you, pig you, even though she likes him. It's that love-hate stuff there. So the main character, Karasuma Yoichi, he is a young guy trying to master his technique, training in the mountains, in the soaring wind, divine wind swordsmanship style under his father's guidance, but now he's like, nothing left to do. Go to a dojo located in the city so he can continue to understand, you know, society. So again, you got this guy walking around looking like Kenshin, the samurai little, you know, cool little getup. That's a cool look. Into a place where there's buildings. People are like, what the hell, you know? And he doesn't know how to act, you know, this. So he acts odd when he talks. And I love his little ye, you know, hey, thee, you know, and so that I think is pretty cool. He ends up living in the dojo with the Ikaruga sisters. Again, typical, he's clueless. And go into many little wonderful misunderstandings. Especially with the beginning when the little lolly girl, uh-oh, call the police. You know, misunderstandings with her and, yeah. And of course, some big revelations we find out about her. Oh my. Anyway, it's a nice, cute little story. 12 episodes. It doesn't conclude, doesn't end, but there's a manga. I have all the manga now, so I'm gonna try and see how that goes and how it really ends. But it's a cute little, charming, fun, funny little entertainment series that has like some neat little messages and themes, and again has some deep down means to it. So yes, it's, you know, ecchi fanservice harem, but it has like nice heart to it, really good heart to it, and characters that I did enjoy liking. We have the sisters. There's the little one, Kagome, you know, 10 years old, you know, the youngest, and again, like I said, some big revelation. She has really big boobs that we find out that she ends up hiding from everyone, bandages them down, and then hilariously falling into the main guy's face. It's like, what the hell? Hers are bigger than Ayame. She's the small little booby sister, a younger sister with little boobies, and she's really cute and has that tsundere personality, shy, and she is, you know, very well that she is, you know, small boobies compared to her other sisters, especially the young one. What the hell? She eventually starts liking our main hero. I felt like I was gearing more towards her because I really do thought she was very cute. She went through so much. I mean, she went through a lot of downs and stuff, being compared to the better, older, the eldest sister, and guys not liking her because she has the small boobs. We're just like, come on, they're cute. She's cute. And, you know, saw that and then all there. But I do really feel like I definitely shipped her with bully, the, you know,
you're a meshy
type of person, you know, that's, you know, bad then turns good, which I like that kind of part of a story. Nice to see that the bully, this guy here, Rough Tough Hash, does have a good heart, the heart of gold, and is a good person. And then joins alongside these people and comes to realize they're good people. And then his little best friend that, with every episode, seems like, I think they did it on purpose, seems like every time you see him interact with this guy, he got shorter and shorter and shorter, until one episode it looked like he was the size of a kid. It's like, are you getting smaller, my best buddy?
Yeah!
But anyway, Ryo Washizu, and then he had his own little vision where he'd see the purple girl that he, of course, admired, which is the one that likes our main Kenshin type of guy. She likes him, he likes her, and then the bully guy likes her, and then he has that vision where it's like, oh, I love you, you're so wonderful, type of stuff like that, which was, you know, funny. But Wasan, he's, you know, his nickname, by his friend Keita, you know, tough guy, and always challenging because he has the crush on our main girl Ibuki, and always has to challenge Yoichi. And little Ayame, you know, I thought she was cute. It was so sweet how she is, had like some good interactions with him. So I'm kind of like, I don't know, I feel like she ended up being best girl for me, because I just, you know, yeah, she had the small boobies, or, you know, not the big boobies, but she, you know, she's so cute and just so shy. And then that, a lot of stuff about her throughout this show that I just really felt like, you know, like she should get more respect and stuff than just being shunned. And I don't know, I felt sorry for her for a lot of times, and I really rooted for her little love interest, and I hope she ends up, you know, with who I think she should end up with. You also have, again, like I said, there's Chihaya, 15-year-old, green hair, really like the green color hair, the glasses, and she has a cute little laugh. She's kind of like a naughty perverted type of thing. You know, she's a manga artist, and yay for manga artists, you know, artists in general. Artists are awesome. You rule the world, people. She's awesome. Ibuki, the main girl, look at her. She's so cute and adorable, and she has a, again, she's very well endowed. I mean, damn. Some good moments with her. Then, of course, I'm getting ahead of myself. She's like the leader of the dojo. She teaches like the young class. She gets the jealous, beaten up, how dare you run into my boobs or my sister's boobs or pussies or something like that, or up my ass or something, and the typical stuff there. But it's because, again, she really likes him. And but she's really good. She's independent. She's tough. She's strong. And she teaches the class, again, like Miss Kaoru. Anyway, the purple hair on the look, like Kaoru, like Urkel. Anyway. So, yeah, she's a great character. They're all great characters. It's fun. They go, most of it is just kind of a simple slice of life kind of story. Then we meet other really good characters. Some of my favorites are Angela Anji and her little friend Tsubasa Tsubame. She's real cute. She's a clumsy, shy girl. She wants a normal life, and she's like really good at cooking. And then there's this thing with Anji, who is Tsubasa's subordinate and is, you know, trains her and then gets her into like these little, like, kind of like the of a finger, and she's underneath her, like, outfit. She's in this really sexy, kinky leather S&M stuff there, and I'm like, hot, yes. And then Angie, she's super busty, jiggly, has the hair covering the eye look, tough girl, wears really good in those Chinese dresses. Oh my gosh, it's so hot. She's so hot and hot. Yeah, she's hot and hot. How many times am I gonna say hot? And then again, you find out it's like when you look at her, like this tall model type of thing there, and then it's like she's 16, and you're like, ah! Boing! Like, she's 16, she looked like she was like 20 or something. I'm like, holy sh**, anime, what do you do? Either way, she's f***ing hot. Good interactions. The opening and ending songs are really good and catchy and sweet. My best bud and I would watch and have fun interaction with the ending and have like our own dialogue, because they'd walk by our main character, Yoichi, and just kind of like, yeah, whatever, you know, like pass by. And it was fun little stuff there with the girls, like they're hitting on him, or and then they like, yeah, well. Anyway, just fun memories there. Great show. It has a really credible storyline. Great characters. It has very good, wonderful comedic moments. It's very enjoyable, fun to watch, epic, and there's also like some hints of a villain, and then like there's this one villain that tries to go after him, then he gets lost, and then that's basically it. Like, you seem like, I'm coming for you from down from the mountains, this big tough guy, like, I'm coming for you, and then he gets lost from, like, you see him in like the sea and all the stuff there, and it's like, the hell, this guy's terrible. He's like, I thought it was hilarious. And then eventually they do, and then they fight, and it's like nothing, and then he kicks their butt. Like, they all like good strong stuff there, good bonding, good friendship messages, funny little series. Wish I would have got more, but at least there's the manga for that. And then there's a bad guy with his sister and the mask, and then, like, throughout the reveal, and then at the end of the anime, he's like, oh, the mask is off, now we're gonna reveal who they are, and they have some stuff there that has, like, a very, for me, it was like, oh no, for the climactic ending with, our main girl, you know, Ibuki, and, what happens to her, and it's very sad, and, like, no, I hope things work out, and very reminiscent of, even though this came up before that, but very reminiscent of the finale of Chuck, season 5 there, between Chuck and Sarah. So it's kind of like that, if anyone knows what I'm talking about. If not, then I'm not going to spoil anything. But a really fun, sexy, cute, ecchi, fan-servicing, touching series. Asu no Yoichi, really fun samurai harem. I give it like maybe an 8, 8.5, 9 out of 10. I really enjoyed it. I like this stuff. Keep it fab.